To me, the big three that I read over and over again are Xenophon, Machiavelli, and Montesquieu. They're my favorites. And I teach them a lot, but I also have learned them. Now I read Thucydides, I teach Thucydides, I teach Plutarch, I teach, you know, all the stuff that you're talking about. They're my favorites. But those are the big three. And then to understand Machiavelli, he has this vast library of sources that he uses. So you really need to know all the Roman, all the ancient historians to understand Machiavelli. You have to really delve into Livy, Tacitus, Suetonius, obviously Plutarch, and then the sort of the lesser Romans that people don't read that much anymore. The historians of Rome like Polybius, Dio Cassius, Dionysius of Halicarnassus, Justin, Josephus, all of these. You know, I don't. Those are not ones that I turn to over and over and over again.
I love that though, because from
you have to read them to get Nick. And usually, if I'm studying him, which I have been lately because I'm teaching a class on the Prince this semester, you know, I always have to go back to the originals because he's always misquoting. You know what I mean? He if he cites a source, you can't take his word for it that he's telling you honest. Like when he talks about Hiero of Syracuse in Prince 6 and in Prince 13, you have to go back to the original in Polybius and compare what Machiavelli says to what Polybius actually says, and you realize Machiavelli's totally manipulating you and lying to you. Then you have to wonder, why does he do it? And if you don't go back to the original source, you will miss what he's playing with you. And he's trying to get you to think something through without telling you what it really is.